So, it's your first day of your apprenticeship. Congratulations, you are on your way to an awesome career in the trades, and especially if I'm a little biased, electrical. However, you have no idea what to expect. In this video, I'm gonna talk to you about 5 things you can expect in your first day and week as an electrical apprentice. Let's get going. Number 1, show up with your tools. Now I know you've probably been told you're not gonna use them. And chances are, you're probably right. I mean, you're gonna be running here and there. There's gonna be a lot of orientation stuff going on. You're gonna be getting to know the site. And then after that, you're gonna basically be a runner. You're gonna be either grabbing stuff for your journeyman or you're gonna be running off to the wholesalers. But it says something when you show up with your tools. At the very least, you should just have your hand tools and a cordless drill, in my opinion. This shows that you're serious about this being an actual career, that this isn't just some job that you're showing up to, that you're serious about this. So I cannot stress enough on that very first day, even though there's a good chance you won't be using them, show up with those tools. It makes a big difference. If you're looking for a list of tools you might need as an electrical apprentice, go on down to the description and I'll put a list right there for you. Number 2, keep your mouth shut and your ears open. There's nothing worse for a journeyman than when their apprentice is just all chatty and acting like they know everything. I'll give you a little hint here. Most journeymen look at their apprentices, especially their first day apprentices, they equate them with kindergarten students. I'm not joking. So make sure that you don't prove them right. Keep your mouth shut and your ears open and do what you're told and you'll be okay. Number 3, this goes a little bit kind of counter to my last point, but this one's important too. It's ask questions. If you don't know what you're doing, then don't just pretend that you do or don't start to do it and just kind of work your way through it hoping you're gonna get it because you might screw things up. So make sure that if you don't understand what's going on, you don't know where you're going to, you don't know what they meant when they asked you to go pick up that EMT, that you ask them what they meant. It's so important to clarify. Now I'm not saying that you're gonna ask questions just for the sake of asking questions, don't do that. But if you need clarification, there is nothing wrong in asking. So ask questions if you need help. Number 4, and this is a big one too that I see happen a lot. When you're done your task, make sure you ask for something else to do. Now I know your journeyman might be busy doing something and maybe you just need to kind of stand off and just wait until they're not so busy, but you need to be looking for the next thing to do. And if you have to wait, look busy. And I know it sounds kind of just funny, well, look busy, but you actually, if you can just go grab a broom and start sweeping stuff up, do something to look busy, but it kind of signals to your journeyman that you're ready for the next task. Also, by staying busy like that, you're signaling to your journeyman that you are ready to actually move on to other things. And that means that they might want to put you into more of a responsible role as opposed to those people who are just sitting out there, they finish their job, and then they just wait to be told what to do next. That drives journeymen crazy. Don't do that. So make sure that as soon as you are done, you look for your journeyman and you ask for the next task. Number 5, it's gonna suck for a while. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. That first week is brutal. Let me tell you this though, it gets easier. Yes, that first week is gonna be the most tired you've ever felt, but at the same time, you're gonna start feeling rewarded by it and you're gonna start getting excited by it. And then you're gonna get your legs under you and your body's gonna get used to it because you're gonna be going up and down ladders, up and down stairs, running here to the C can and there to the van. You're gonna be getting lots of tools. You've got to be carrying tools on your hips that you're not used to. Your body's not used to this kind of work. Do not stress out. It's going to be okay. We all go through it. That first week is exhausting. Now that being said, let me just give a little caveat here. If you find yourself in a situation with your boss that has become abusive, then that's not okay. And you need to get out of there because it's not okay. That's old school and we don't do things like that anymore. We're changing the culture here, right? We're not going to allow abusive behavior to happen on our sites anymore. And if you treat people with respect, especially your apprentices, I'm speaking to the journeyman here, your apprentices are gonna treat you with respect as well. I'm gonna give you one last one. Number 6, get off those phones. Now I'm not saying don't snap pictures because you're proud of the work, that's okay. But make sure it's at a time when you're done the work or you're about to take coffee break or it's lunchtime. But those who are pulling out their phones all the time and on them all the time, they get noticed and next time there's a layoff coming, they're the ones first to go. Take pictures and that sort of thing and Snapchats and send them to your buddies on your own time. Do not do it on the boss's time. That stuff gets noticed very, very quickly. Okay, that's all I got for today. If you have stuff you'd like to add, please, I'd love to hear it. Put it in the comments down below. I would love to hear what other journeymen are saying about this. What are some of the things that you think that apprentices should know their first week? And you that are in your apprenticeship, what are some things that you've experienced in your first week that you'd like to pass on to others and just to make their lives a little bit easier? If you're getting any value from this, make sure you do me a favor, hit subscribe, it gets the word out there, and hit that bell for notifications. You'll be notified as soon as the video comes out. They're coming out once or twice a week, so they're fast and furious, you don't want to miss them. We'll see you in the next one.